爱情一落成一季，想相信刻画成回忆，想念几个世纪才是刻骨铭心。若能回到冰河时期，冬夏把你抱进橱里，你的笑多疗愈，让人生也苏醒。失去你的风景，像座废墟，像失落文明。能否一场奇迹，一线生机，能不能又再一次相遇？想见你，只想见你，未来过去，我只想见你。穿越了千个万个时间线里，人海里相依，用尽了逻辑心机推理爱情最难解的谜。会不会你也和我一样，在等待一句我愿意。时光更迭了四季，让宇宙无幻或心意，永远都退流行，是青涩的真心。未来先进科技无法模拟你拥抱暖意，如果另个时空另个身体，能不能换另一种结局？想见你，只想见你，未来过去，我只想见你。穿越了千个万个时间线里，人海里相依，用尽了逻辑心机推理爱情最难解的谜。会不会你也和我一样，在等待一句我愿意。想见你，只想见你，未来过去，我只想见你。穿越了千个万个时间线里，人海里相依，用尽了逻辑心机推理爱情最难解的谜。在等待一句我愿意，在等待一句我愿意。
Thank you so much. This song is called 想见你想见你想见你 by 八三幺。 And I know you guys miss your friends, miss your relatives a lot, but because now it's a very, very delicate situation, right? So please stay safe as much as you can at home. Just go out for your necessary stuff when you buy your groceries and stuff. And of course, if the elderly at home needs help, please help them go and get your stuff, their stuff also. So and hope you guys like this song. And with this song, I hope you guys also try different ways and methods to also connect with the people that you miss online and also all digital platforms that you can find. So yeah, thank you so much and see you guys.
Yay! 我愿意
很有心的
No, this is what I want to say, right? To my friends who will be asking me out, because now we can dine out in 5. Yes, if you are vaccinated. So if you only got vaccinated, right? Then you can call me out. If not, you better don't call me out. Like 直接
Hey, I'm getting my second dose tomorrow.
Yay! Congrats, 直接 you're getting your dose tomorrow.
Yeah, finally I'm getting my dose.
Very good.
Fully vaccinated.
Amazing.
Yeah, then I can maybe enjoy a meal outside after 2 weeks, of course. After the second dose. So I'm looking forward to it.
Okay, very good. So right now you only can hang out in two, right?
Yep.
Groups of two, okay? Mm-hmm. And then if you're fully vaccinated, you can have up to 5 distinct household guests per day. Mm-hmm. Yes, and that's quite a significant jump lah from 2.
Yeah, so if you are unvaccinated, not fully vaccinated like me, just 2 packs. I mean, to me, right now, before I get my second dose, I'm fine with 2 packs.
Yeah.
To keep myself safe, to prevent the likelihood of transmission.
Correct.
Yeah,
correct.
And it's hard for me to find 5 friends.
Have lah.
Yeah.
I'm sure you have. I also have lah. 很勉強的有啦有五個朋友啦 but it's okay. I mean as much as possible we can limit like you know our social circle right now. Hopefully things will get better and then next time then we can all go out and enjoy more.
Yeah, I mean just because you are fully vaccinated, right? And then you are allowed to like go out in 5 packs, dine in 5.
Yeah.
That doesn't mean you are bulletproof, okay?
Yeah.
You might still be infected.
Yeah.
But although the risk is being cut down by a lot. But still, of course, try to stay home whenever you can. If there's no need to head out, no need to dine out, please just stay home, stay safe.
Correct. And right, we've been talking so much, right? But we haven't told you about today. Today's live, we're gonna have 2 special guests today.
Yep.
Okay, just like, if you're not vaccinated, you can have 2. So today we have 2 special guests. And for the first one, we have a chef, Ivan Yeo. And the second one is a singer.
Yep, we have Marcus Lee with us. And both are actually very talented.
Yes.
Yes.
They all have talents that me and Zijie don't have.
No, you don't have, I do have.
You have there, you have what? You have what talent?
Okay, my talent might not be their talent, but it's linked. Related.
Like
okay,
what?
Chef Ivan is a very good cook.
Yeah?
He can make fantastic food.
Yeah.
Me, I'm very good at eating.
He煮我吃.
Go ahead, we are a team.
Huh,
you'll never win me, Kim.
Are you sure?
When it comes to lose, 你就是妹妹.
Hey! Okay, let's ask Chef Ivan if it really is like together, comes hand in hand, okay?
Okay, let's welcome Chef Ivan Yeo!
Yay!
Hello guys! Hi!
Hello! Okay. How have you been?
Like everybody else. I mean, as chefs, as people in the industry, in a restaurant, we are always in the restaurant. We're trying, always finding ways to make things better, how people can enjoy the food better, because now it's mostly delivery.
So
without music as well in the restaurants, it's actually quite almost like a isolation ward, you know.
Oh.
So every set, so we were, you know, the different colleagues will all sit together and we'll tell stupid jokes with each other during the downtime.
Uh-huh.
And And we've been enjoying as well. We've been finding ways to cook very fantastic staff meals.
Amazing.
So staff meals have been very, very luxurious recently.
Wow, that's amazing. Okay, so the last time that we met Chef Ivan Yeo, right? Actually it was before it was 2 years ago. Then what he was doing was he was teaching me and Zijie how to cook separately lah. Each one he taught a different kind of dish.
Yep.
Yeah. So can you remember who was the better chef?
Who was better, me or Kim?
Can you remember?
I remember getting quite worried about you.
Why?
Because if I was not wrong, you were trying to butcher the fish. And it was a little bit slippery, right? So, I don't know, you were very close misses, hit and misses, you know, fingers and all. So I was like, okay.
But it turned out well, didn't it?
It turned out well. It turned out well. Okay, it turned out well.
I mean, I'm an actor. I like to make the scene a little bit more dramatic.
Okay, but if you don't know what we're talking about, you can go to Facebook. You can go to Noon Talk Media's Facebook page and then you can find the episodes where Chef Ivan Yeo is actually teaching us how to cook.
Yeah. And Kimberly was always trying to hide from the splash.
No, I was.
Yeah, which she didn't get anything done. Nothing was done.
It was a good food. I cut the oranges, I remember.
Yes, very good oranges.
So you might be wondering, oranges, fish, what kind of dish are those? So I believe our viewers are actually very interested. Mm. What kind of dishes or cuisine do you specialize in?
So I basically specialize mostly in Asian dishes, Asian cuisine. But I think the last 4 or 5 years, I've been very specialized into trying to bring back and celebrate the heritage, my heritage of Teochew, right?
Oh, so we do I'm a lot.
You're Teochew now also?
I'm also Teochew, yes.
No wonder so pretty.
Oh, thank you. Yes, they say Teochew got very pretty girl.
Yes, that's right, that's right. That's right. But so they also say Teochew very Haolian, so.
Okay, that's very funny. I don't know. I don't know about that.
No, no, we'll let the people vote. La.
Okay, yeah. Who else here is Teochew? Y'all can tell us in the comments, okay? Then we can all be chill and Haolian together.
Yeah, so okay. We've been celebrating and trying to bring back the heritage of Teochew flavors. Mm-hmm. So I think a lot of people misunderstand Teochew food as Teochew mui, bland, boring, steam, boiled. But it's actually contrary to that. There's actually so many things that are really exciting that Teochew foods can offer.
Wow. Yeah, okay. So, yeah. You need to tell me a little bit more about it because I'm Teochew. Actually, I don't really know.
I thought you said you like to eat.
I like to eat.
She don't even know how to cook the plain porridge.
I know. I mean, so not doesn't matter, right? I don't know.
It matters. So the basic porridge, it's 潮州人我们要讲究啦, 所以那个饭其实是泡饭. So it's actually poached rice. So the rice has to be solid, individual grains.
Like right? In soup.
Yeah, but with rice water.
Wow.
So you cannot cook it to the point whereby the rice become almost like the Hokkien style or the Cantonese style, the mushy one.
Yeah.
So that one is a totally different style.
Okay.
Nothing wrong. It's just different styles. Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
Wow, Teochew food. Oh, I need to explore more. Okay, yeah. I cannot embarrass my own. Yeah, heritage.
I mean, I cannot believe how when she said, when she was like so into it, like, yeah, Teochew people are very pretty. Then, food, oh, 我不会煮. 粥都不懂怎么煮.
你会吗? 你会吗? I think one day maybe Chef Ivan can come and teach me again. We have another cooking session.
Yes, we will.
Yeah, and if you are too eager, you can't wait to see him in action. I believe we have some videos to show to our viewers of you being in action.
Wow!
日本潮州鱼粥是一份潮州人的爱语, 那鱼汤也就是那份爱的灵魂。 潮州鱼汤清而不淡, 咸而不腻, 每家都有各自的秘诀, 用的食材也有各家的特色。 在食材上, 虽然有稍微的不一样, 可是煮出来的汤, 都会有那个特别, 又熟悉的潮州风味。 鲜甜的海鲜风味, 从那锅中散发出来, 在空中隐隐约约地漂浮着, 闻了都给人一种愉悦的感觉。 要熬一锅鱼汤, 并不难, 要熬出一锅能传达潮州人的爱意的鱼汤, 才难。 你最近想煮潮州鱼汤吗? 你最近给亲人传达爱意了吗?
哇，很有feel嘞！
真的很有feel耶， got the
要爱， yeah. 潮州人是讲爱的。
哇，感觉你，
damn.
你喂了我们的肚子， 又喂了我们的灵魂。
Soup for Teochew fish
yes.
soup for the soul.
Yes.
Wow, so that's your 拿手好菜.
I think not really, because there are some core dishes in Teochew cuisine. So some of the things, the basics, you cannot run. Mm-hmm. So the soups, the sauces, the porridge that we are talking about
yes.
now. So all these things are very critical. So Teochew cuisine, in simple terms, if a lot of people don't understand, is really like what Teochew mui is mm-hmm. about. But instead of looking at each of these dishes as a dish, you should look at them as building blocks. So from things like why our porridge is so bland, mm-hmm. right? Because you have your things like salted egg,
yes,
your pickled olives,
yes,
and all the kiam, something right?
Yeah,
something right? So each of these dishes are actually building blocks. So when you pile them on, it's salt on salt on salt on flavors. So you need to have a kind of like an empty canvas to hold it in.
Wow.
So that is what the porridge is about.
Nice.
So instead of like in the French cuisine, you have like 4 to 5 mother sauces, but in Teochew cuisine, we have actually 128 different condiments.
What?
So the pairing of mix and matches between all these different building blocks comes up with a new dish. So a very good example is probably like steamed fish.
Yeah.
So the 那个蒸的那个鲳鱼. So usually you have like tomatoes, you have gamchai, all that stuff, right? Those individual ingredients are actually individual dishes that can hold on their own. So if you have good dishes, you pile good dishes together, they would form an even better dish.
Yes.
So
yes,
that's basically the ideology of Teochew cuisine.
Wow, that's amazing. Okay, so we have a lot of viewers who are watching now, right? 8K over viewers, and they're all saying training word says a handsome chef with good skills.
Thank you.
And then Jolene also says the food looks very good. So where can we find your food?
Okay, so our flagship store is actually at Juchet. So it's called the 1925 Brewing Company Juchet.
Okay.
Right, so...
1925?
Yeah.
Why 1925?
Well, it's actually founded... 1925 is actually founded between myself, my brother and my uncle.
Okay.
So the common point, the common point is that I'm my Akong. So my Akong's birth year is 1925. So he was, of course, one of the first generation Teochews born in Singapore, and then he was doing dry goods grocery, mostly Teochew dry goods.
Okay.
So from young, we kind of grew up helping him in the market, you know, free labor, basically. Free labor. You know, do this, do that, do this, or that. So those were kind of like the lifestyle we were leading as primary school children and all that stuff. So we thought that it was very nice to pay tribute to the old man. And put the year as a form of respect.
Wow, that's very, very sweet.
Yeah.
It's at Juchet.
It's at Juchet, so it's in the KTV places. But no KTV, because don't worry, all gone already.
Oh no, okay.
Our neighbours are quite law-abiding, so
okay,
quite good.
Okay, that's good.
Then right now, right, since we are allowed to dine out,
yeah.
How's you and your staff coping?
Actually, there's a lot of things that I think customers don't actually see behind the scenes, like, you know, just like us filming, we have a lot of things behind the scenes that people don't see. So waiters or the servers, the front of house people will have to now take on an additional job of vetting through whether you're vaccinated, whether you're from the same household.
Yeah.
And of course, this entire package comes with a whole list of other questions as well.
Yeah.
You know, different combinations. I'm from a different household, but we stay together, we rent the house together, blah, 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 and all the different permutations. So we have to keep explaining.
Mm.
We have some nice ones, of course, very friendly, courteous and polite, but we also have nasty ones. So on the first day when we can do the dine-in, right?
Yeah.
So we have people who come in and say, hey, I've vaccinated, but it's not 2 weeks.
Mm.
Right?
Yeah! So okay, yeah, this one we really need to let people know, okay? Because I've seen a lot of people talking about it on social media. You really have to wait 2 weeks after your second dose to be considered fully vaccinated, okay? I think really, you just have to abide to the law now, okay? And then don't give all the, like, restaurants a hard time, because they're just doing their job, you know? Just making everywhere safe for everyone.
Yeah, so I think we have a lot of different customers who are, of course, quite offended lah, because we had to do the policing. So, but luckily, I got the very nice, dainty little girl waitress, female waitresses. So, uncle, 对不起, 不要骂我, you know, the kind of thing, teary eye and mask and all that. So we are quite lucky. Yeah.
I see.
Yeah.
Wow. So, was it tough during the
that period? It's a little bit harder because, same thing, most restaurants. I mean, we were sharing off camera just now earlier, that most food F&B people, right, they are kind of classified between two categories generally. So one is, of course, the people who are doing online.
Mm-hmm.
The online ones that do better will usually be the stores, like, for example, hawkers, or maybe stores that focus on a certain type of foods, like, for example, noodles.
Yes.
Right. So it's all either dry noodles, that stuff, right? But for restaurants, we are based on courses. So your appetizers, mains and all that. So usually you have this over a period of 45 minutes.
Yeah.
So it's harder to cram all the 45 minutes into a 10-minute delivery.
Mm.
Preparation for delivery and pickup and everything else. And the food doesn't travel well. So for some of us who are more risk takers, like adventurers, we will have to revamp the entire menu. So that means other things follows, like marketing, we have to take photos, we have to do additional promotion, etc, etc.
Wow, so do you do all those yourself?
Yes,
the photos and the videos?
Yeah.
Just now that video is you do yourself?
Yes.
No way!
Well, I wrote the script, I did the storyboarding, so I have a team. I mean, in-house we have a good team of these two girls, who are really, really talented. They've been with us for about 3 years now. So they do the filming, and then I do the splicing, editing, and all the sound. So that, because these are things that I usually do in my previous life.
Ah, your previous life.
Yes, previous life.
What was your previous life?
I was a creative director and an agency before.
Ah. Wow! This is called talent, eh? Multi-talent.
Because I couldn't make it, that's why I became a chef.
No way! The video was super well done.
Yeah, I was like, who do you get to do all this?
Yeah, who's the director? Who's the cameraman? Wow!
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Like, putting everything to very good use.
Yes, so everything that I've accumulated over the course of my life, from music to understanding what touches people, stories, storytelling. So I kind of infuse that a lot into my business as well. Mm. So I think people, especially now, I think F&B people really like this, and especially Asian chefs. So we have, honestly, we have people who are more talented than I am, and they've been working their butts off for the past 30 years, but silently working.
Ah.
Right. So like my akong, you know, or my ama, my mom's side, my ama used to sell very famous kuay chap. So now you ask her, yeah, when she was alive, when I ask her, you know, ama, how teach me this recipe? Yeah. Very easy one, very easy one.
Everything
also very easy one. You know, it's like there is no value to the things you do because this is what you tell people.
Uh-huh.
Hence, people will believe it and there shouldn't be a value. So kuay chap is how much? $3.50 for a big plate of everything that takes maybe 2 days to make.
Wow.
It doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
Right, so how do you expect people to have that value placed on you when you keep telling other people that it is easy to do what you're doing?
Right.
So I try to change that. So I don't want to also be too arrogant and say it was very hard.
Yeah.
It's not. Right, it's just that it takes a lot of time, it takes a lot of dedication to do certain things, and we want to translate it into stories for people to connect and remember. So the younger folks like you guys will not be shy to say, I want to eat in a Teochew restaurant, I want to eat Teochew food, I want to eat, I don't know, or any other heritage-based foods, right? So I think this is the way to kind of inculcate this idea.
Yeah.
I mean, that sounds like quite a lot of work. I mean, you have to constantly, you need time to prepare your food, your ingredients, and then to perfect the skill set, and then your advertising, everything, how to manage the restaurant itself.
Uh-huh.
So, having so many things on hand, right? What about family?
Wow. I think I'm very, very lucky to have quite a supportive family. So, very clearly, I live very close to my mom and dad, right? So, for obvious reasons, because there's a familial support.
Yes.
Right. So also because it's also easy with my brother when we need to meet for business.
Right. Oh, okay.
Then
the whole family is chefs,
No. My brother is actually the beer brewer. He's the brewmaster.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Amazing. So he does all the beers. So anything that's got to do with beverages, he handles the B side. I handle the F side.
Oh, that's a really coming hand in hand.
The family right hand of F. Yeah, correct.
Yeah.
Very good.
So the tough one, of course, is my wife. She has to handle the family, the home stuff, you know, all the nitty gritty stuff. On her own as much as she can, with my 4-year-old son as well. And now she's expecting the second one.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So
wow,
so
congrats.
people bought during COVID. So we must, listen to the 政府 the 招考, right?
Yes.
Get the baby grants.
Get the baby grants, yes. Yeah.
Good. Wow.
And of course, the other people, I think close friends as well. We have a group of people who are very supportive.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if they're watching. I think Nicole, Ruben, these people, they should be watching. They've been supportive. They are also cooped up at home, but they will deliberately buy products, food from us,
right,
to deliver to ourselves, to us.
Oh, so cute!
So it's quite funny. So it's quite cute. And then they'll send foods to us as well. And then, they send within their own community. So these are people.
Oh, you can say hi to your friends.
Hello, then. Hello everybody. Hi Nicole, hi Ruben, hi everybody. If you're watching, hi Phoebe, hi mom and dad.
So cute!
Yeah.
To my friends, please send me food as well.
Yeah, buy from Chef Ivan at 1925 and then send it to us.
Yes, I would love some food, thanks.
Also, I also heard that your parents, you were telling us that your parents actually go down to your restaurant to visit you.
Yes, so that's the only time they can kind of see me, other than the fact that I go back home and take over the babysitting when my wife, because my wife's a singer.
Right. Oh.
Right. So she performs at some of these online shows as well that you see here and there nowadays. So we switch shift lah. You know?
Okay, that's
so
cute.
So I take over the night shift and she does what she needs to do.
I see.
Mm.
Wow.
I mean that's great. Are they fully vaccinated already?
My wife not yet because same thing like me. I'm an anaphylactic shock. An anaphylactic allergy.
Oh, okay.
So I just got my clearance. So I just got my first shot. So I'm supposed to take my second shot on 25th.
Great.
So for my wife, obviously she is now heavily pregnant. Obviously we are listening to doctor's orders. Hold it off a little bit.
Yes.
Don't make her suffer too much.
Yeah. No, go for checks lah. If you're unsure of whether or not you can be vaccinated, just go to the doctor and ask them to check.
Yes.
Yeah.
So I got a clearance. It's actually very nice. They actually sent me a memo that I brought to the vaccination center.
Uh-huh.
So I gave them to them.
Extra care and everything.
Extra care. Good. Still got Milo and chocolate. Biscuit standby for me. So it was quite nice. Yeah. I still asked me to want to sit in the stretcher and wait. So I sat there for about an hour.
Okay. See, very safe.
Better be safe,
yeah.
Guys, now it's really, you really have all the reasons in the world to get vaccinated, okay? So please get vaccinated. Your friends around you, encourage them to get vaccinated.
Yes.
The old folks at home, bring them down to get fully vaccinated. And they can go out and enjoy meeting their friends and stuff.
Yes.
Yep. So just do it.
Yes. So if you're up to, if you're fully vaccinated, again, it's groups of up to 5 people, okay? So, so many benefits to be fully vaccinated. Yeah,
yep.
Just go. No other reason, just go.
If not, you'll be like me, 2 packs like that.
I mean, nah, it's fine. 反正你也是在家吃.
Sometimes, hey, just 2 days ago, it happened to me, you know. I call my friend, we stay very near each other, ma. I was like, hey, want go eat or not? They're like, still got who? They're like, me lo, don't want.
You see, this is why you don't have friends, because whatever, you reject alone. Your friends.
They cook making me.
Oh no!
So, both vaccinated and unvaccinated persons can dine in the hawker center, okay? And coffee shop from since like 10th.
Yes. Yep.
And then subject to just a packs of 2.
Yes.
So right now, all I can go for, coffee shop.
Yes, and hawker centers.
Yes.
Anyway, support local food, right?
Yes.
Yeah. And when you're dining out, also remember to always keep your mask on, except for when you're eating or drinking. Yeah, don't the drinks come, but you're not drinking, then you take off your mask.
Yeah.
I mean, just wear it, just wear it.
I mean, we do know that the recent updates, there are quite a few changes and updates to changes. So, in case you're unsure of anything, remember, the best place to check it out is at gov.sg.
Yeah.
Yeah, and whatever news you hear from your friends, from you see online, just check it out on gov.sg. Yeah, to be safe.
Yeah. Oh, we also asking we also have viewers asking if Chef Ivan is award-winning chef.
Yes.
He's right. Yeah, I think they already know.
So in 2020, I was very honored to be given the title the Asian Chef of the Year.
Whoa!
So
congratulations.
Thank you.
Wow.
So that was very So these are my guys. So interesting part is, Sarah. So Sarah has been with me for the past 8 years from the beginning of our business.
Great.
So the interesting part is she's actually a Malay Muslim.
Okay.
All right, Malay. She was always at the manager at the front of house.
Okay.
But she has this chao bina, very angry. She's really angry, just like me. Very angry.
No.
So we are working in that mood, right? We are, you know, that
focused.
Face. Focused.
Yeah, it's the game face on.
So I said, hey, Sarah, why don't you join me to the dark side, join the kitchen? You have the perfect attitude and the temperament for it.
I see.
So she just said, okay. She took up the challenge and she started cooking. And it was
so
incredible.
She didn't know how to cook prior.
No, she's just like home cooking,
simple stuff.
Like, okay. Yeah, but of course, because I saw that the advantage is that she was a Malay as well. What's the best of the Malays? They have the good chilies.
Oh yeah.
Right, they understand chilies very well. So when she took over, she obviously was very passionate about it. She started taking the chilies and said, hey Ivan, this chili not very good, we change this. And all my chilies are all made by her. So,
Amazing. So
in 14 months after she joined the kitchen, we actually did a omakase, which is a very special, kind of like a chef feature.
Yeah.
So she became the head chef for that day, and she took over everything and designed a course, a 6-course meal, in a Malay heritage style, all the Malay heritage foods lah. So your bergedils and all that stuff, so misoto, but all jazzed up, right? She actually sold the tickets faster than when I did my omakase.
So it's really impressive. Yeah.
Very
so she's
impressive.
Actually very talented. I love her. I always tell people she's actually my work wife.
Because, oh no!
Yeah, she's my work wife now. Yeah. I love her to max. I know that she's. I can be here because she's actually taking the helm right now.
That's amazing.
Yeah. So she's doing everything. And of course, Zong Yan, the other little small girl.
Yeah.
She has actually moved on to now start a chain of this bar chor mee stalls.
Wow. So all your 徒弟 all go on to do like everything that they can. That's amazing, eh?
Yeah. That's not too bad.
And just now you were saying, right, when you are in the kitchen, you have this very angry face.
Can we see?
Yeah. Okay, this one is post lah. This one was actually quite interesting because this was actually the dish I designed for a recent program for Channel News Asia.
Right.
It was a documentary where I did an exploration down Orchard Road. So to discover the history of Orchard Road and how it kind of influenced our food in Singapore.
Okay.
So at the end of it all, the tough part was to kind of design a meal that kind of holds all these stories.
I see. And fish.
Yes.
Wow.
You don't have to do fish, of course.
Hey, this okay lah. No, don't.
This one's smiling. This one is post one lah. This one
still
is
very
post.
Handsome.
This is post. So you have more fiercer shots. Really fiercer shots. So now it's worse because the mask is on, right?
All right, only the eyes are only the eyes.
So people, they'll stay away. Yeah, usually they will stay away. Yeah, it's so funny.
So but, how will we know when you will have your omakase dinners? You know, because I would want to try one day for sure.
So because we are located at Zijie, so we have a lot of regulars that come by. We see them about 4 to 5 times a week.
Okay.
Right, so they cannot obviously eat the same foods every damn time. Right. So all the thing is how they come is that they will say, hey, Ivan, can we cook something special for you, for us? And you just order up. Or else you can just let me know your dietary restrictions and you let me know about 3 days beforehand. We'll get the products and we'll do the design. We'll design the entire menu for you.
Wow. It's like customized.
Specifically, yes, customized. So we kind of function like a community kitchen, more like a community kitchen, yeah.
Okay. Yep.
Wow. Hey, Kim.
Huh? Okay. Let's go. Let's go. Okay. How can we look for you? We look for you on your IG, can or not?
Yes, you can look right? on your IG. Of course, you can look for me at chef underscore Ivan Yeo.
Okay, yeah, there right? we have it on
yes,
the screen
wow.
there.
Fantastic.
Ta-da! Okay, you can look at all his very nice food photos.
Yes. Yeah, be cautious. Please do not open his IG page at night. Nighttime before you sleep. No, just don't do it.
Yes. Okay, thank you so much.
Thank
chef.
You guys for having me.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Yay! Wow! Wow! I wish I could cook so well. I think 我会很肥啊，如果我，你有没有想过啊？得那么厉害？你有没有？你会不会希望以后你的老公很会煮 ？Of course, 我当然希望啊 ，but 他不能怪我啦。如果我老公很会煮 ，then 我一直吃 right， 他不能怪我。如果我肥的话，他不可以嫌弃我。 Yeah, that's the bottom line. That's all.
没关系啦，他可以喂的肥，你也是厉害了。 我认识你这么久，你都吃不胖的。有啦，一点点
，OK， exercise， keep
yes,
fit.
After, like satisfying your eyes with all the food,
yes.
your ears hearing about all the delicious meals that you can get to eat.
Yeah.
Next, we are going to bless your ears.
Ooh, I'm very happy.
Someone with a very beautiful voice.
Yes.
Yes, we have Marcus. Hi, Marcus.
Hello, Marcus.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
Hi, everybody.
We wanna say hi to everybody.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay. Your
hi, guys. Name. Hello, hello.
Yeah. You
want to
introduce yourself?
Oh, sorry. Yeah, my name is Marcus Li Junwei and I'm a local singer-songwriter. Yeah.
Wow, amazing! Okay, so actually our program, right? We planned it very
well.
Our first guest came, right?
Yeah.
Is Sean Tok.
Oh,
and then after that, okay. we had Ben.
Yeah,
and now we have
week,
you!
Yeah. Yeah. Cool, 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 cool.
Yeah, so
we have... 刚好也是按照那个 competition 顺序.
Oh, 是吗?
Sean is the winner, Ben is second, I'm third. For the second season of Campus Superstar.
这么巧啊!
这个是节目组安排的啊,跟我们没有关系啊。刚好,刚好,对对对。
Wow! Okay, okay, does it bring back any memories
for you? It does, it does. Actually, I was just on the Sheng Sheng show with Michelle. Michelle, on a... Just a few weeks back, and then seeing Zheng Yong Da-ge really brought back a lot of memories lah. Because the competition was like 14 years ago, back in 2007. Yeah, so really, really like it's been a long while lah. Also, it was a good stock take of the journey so far. So really like thankful for the whole process and the journey lah.
Wow.
Okay. Going to Sheng Sheng Show, right?
Yeah.
As we all know, is for certain type of promotion or
yes,
performance
yes.
or anything.
Oh, right.
So, what's new?
I recently just released my debut album.
Woo!
Yeah, so
congratulations!
It's called 为了你我可以, For You I Can.
Oh, 为了谁写的?
为了你，曾经爱过的你，被爱的你，跟期待下一个爱情的你。
Kimberly听了要哭了，很有感触哎。
I mean to share a bit more, like the album also takes you through a journey of love, you know, in three different stages. The first one is 悲伤的怀念, reminiscing in sadness, and moving on to like 幸福的回忆, sweet memories, and then the final chapter, the 第三篇章是未来的希望, which is like new hope for tomorrow. So the songs comprise, I mean the album comprises of songs that I've released before. I released about 5 or 6 singles, and then this album has like 5 new, completely new songs. So yeah, I think that's just something for everyone. Whether you're going through a tough time, or you know you're going through quite a happy time, or you're looking to you know towards the future with some hope. I think there's something for everyone lah. Yeah, in this album.
How long did it actually take to produce this album?
So I released, because some of the songs were released before, so I start my first single, 这是我的表白, My Confession, was released in end of 2019.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, then I released a couple of singles last year, and then it was only maybe sometime late last year where I decided, okay, 我要做一个 like one 合集. At first was an EP.
Okay.
Then I was thinking, but I already had like 5 or 6 songs in mind, which is kind of like EP, 多几首歌就成为一个 album.
Yeah, so might as well.
So I squeezed a little bit out of myself, you know, to take a look at some of the songs that I have written, ideas lah, and then finish it up. Like, I think that I started working on these new songs maybe in February.
Okay.
Yeah, then I got it done by like around April and May. Yeah, and then it just got released last week, last Friday.
Oh, yeah. Wow, that's good progress. Yeah.
But is it because right now you're staying home a lot more? Like because COVID, we're staying home already, but
I mean, I think COVID definitely changed a lot of plans. I think if last year, you know, I wanted to go overseas to shoot some of the MVs, but you know, things got changed, so definitely had to recalibrate. And so even for right now with this album, I also want to do more promotion, so I have to do it in a different way. So I think COVID also taught me to also level up and upskill in different areas, especially in the whole digital realm, the online platforms, which I'm so thankful for.
Yeah. We give you one chance to promote now, okay? Can you sing for us, please?
Yeah, yeah, sure. I mean, I'm here to sing, right?
So, yay! Sure. Yeah. Amazing, okay. Which song are you going to sing for us?
So the first song I'll sing, the 主打歌 of this album, the main song, the leading song, which is called 请给我多一次机会, called One More Chance. And then this song is written from a place of regret. You know, sometimes, you know, when you feel like you just at the stage of breaking up, I think a lot of times we would feel like if I did something differently, would the ending be different? So this song captures the essence of those emotions.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Take it away.
一场太阳月亮依然在转但是仍无法忘记我们之间的甜蜜心中不停弹奏回你写的旋律惭愧心情独自收藏 脑海里是一片空荡为何瞬间说的话产生多么痛的遗憾我不是故意的要你受伤请给我多一次的机会 给我多一次的机会微风吹过的午后握住你的双手让我再陪你看细水长流请给我多一次的机会 让我再一次把时间找回在你什么我都愿意这是我的决定就算风吹雨打为你我会勇敢爱着你 握住你的双手让我再陪你看细水长流请给我多一次的机会请让我再一次把世界找回
听到那个转音
有啦，这么好听。Oh my gosh,
can I just see right?
Yes.
How I wish I've listened to this song, using this song like maybe a month ago.
Why?
Why?
Because this exact same line, right?
你过来啊！你刚分手啊？你什么？
不啦。Okay, 因为我在拍的戏吗？戏里面我说的最多的一句话，这是其中一句。
真的假的？哪一句话 ？Which?
给我多一次机会哦！哇！那当然，我 NG 的时候我也是这样说啊。哎、欸、，sorry， 给我多一次。哈哈
哈哈哈哈！对，好笑。
But our viewers in the comment section, they love the song. They love your singing voice.
Yes. Tommy Kenner says, "Wow, he's really attractive when he sings." And we have also Travels who says, "His Chinese is very good."
Oh my gosh! Wow, thank you so much.
Did you write the song yourself?
Yeah. So this one, in terms of like lyrics and melody, this is my own. Yeah. So some of the songs, most of it is like my own compositions, but also some of them were written with other writers as well. Yeah. But this one is my own lah. Actually, come quite a long way in terms of Chinese, because actually I'm more of English speaking.
Me too.
Yeah.
We also have viewers, Sweetheart YZ, saying that when you were singing, she said that she wants to download your song.
Oh, yeah.
So where can they find your song?
Oh. Yep, so it's available on all digital streaming platforms. So your Spotify, KKBOX, Apple Music, Joox, everywhere, YouTube as well. And then for this song, there's going to be an MV. Yeah,
oh, so
it'll be coming out one day after National Day Parade, so 22nd.
Okay.
Yeah, so you can check out.
所以是已经拍了，
已经拍完了，对。
你没有机会了啦，你没有机会做女主。
Next time, there's other songs.
我没有讲东西。But okay, 如果你要的话，你可以想我。
Okay,
think of me, 不是想我。
Just now when you were singing, right? I could tell that you really had a lot of emotions in you, and then you really sang with a lot of emotions.
真感情。
Yeah, so what inspired this song?
Actually, this song, 说白了就是at first it was just plainly for the melody. I remember just this line 的，就是那个副歌第一句，请给我多一次机会。Just and this melody kept replaying. So I just had this idea in mind. I didn't work on it. I just had like chorus that kind of thing. And then it was only until the album came out, you know, I was thinking about this idea of 请给我多一次机会。And also together with my own experiences, you know, 我也是有错过的爱情。There was a period of time where maybe I was not strong enough, 不够勇敢。So I wrote these things into the song. So and also hearing some friends' experiences here and there, all together. Like, I think as a musician, as a creative, we get our inspiration from everywhere. Like other music, movies, from friends, everywhere.
Yes, true. And you see, Zijie is very sad suddenly. I don't know why.
好伤感哦 I don't know. And I mean, just after hearing the song, it puts a lot of emotions in
you.
And actually, that's what I love so much about music. Be you are singing, 你在抒发你的感情，你在可以做一种发泄，你可以表达你要表达的东西。听的人呢会被音乐影响。Music can really change. You really absorb what you hear, right?
Yeah.
And it can really help you relax. So, music can aid mental wellness a lot.
It is. It really is. Eh? Do you use music to actually help your like mental wellness?
And definitely. I think as a musician, sometimes to pursue this path, like there's quite a lot of self-doubt, and there's like it's a bit hard to know to pursue music. And sometimes I also have my own expectations, being like quite a perfectionist. So, definitely listening to music, actually writing songs is also my own process of
like, outlet.
To 散发这些心情 Actually, in the album, there's also another song called "I Don't Wanna Be This Way" that talks about this, like self-doubt and depression, like. You know, a lot of times we are stuck in this dichotomy, like angel and devil, you know?
Yeah.
Like we want to encourage ourselves, but at the same time, there's also some part of ourselves that put ourselves down. So I wrote that song also to like say, you know, I don't want to be like that. You know, I want to, you know, appreciate, be more grateful, encourage myself, celebrate the small wins.
Wow.
That kind of things.
Okay.
Yeah. And,
Why?
The song sounds like it suits my role so much.
You go and listen.
Yeah, you go and listen. Okay, because go now.
My role, right? In the show, Bie Lai Wu Yang, which I just done filming today. Yes. Yeah, just
really?
Done today.
Rest?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, that's why I'm getting my vaccine tomorrow.
Cool.
Yes. So in the show, I'm acting as someone who's got depression.
Yeah.
And then, so for this show, right, I actually did a lot of research on mental wellness.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then, of course, in the show, there are counseling and stuff. Which, actually, from my research, right, and I just want to tell everyone, you do not need to have, like, a serious problem or depression or anything to look for help or go for a counselor. Go to a counselor.
Yes,
counselors, actually, their job, right, is just to listen to you, like, express what you feel. They can help to improve your relationship with friends and family.
Yeah, I think they can really see clearly about everything. Because sometimes you're in the situation, I don't know, but as a personal experience, like, if you're in the situation, sometimes you don't know what's going on around you. So maybe talking to someone will actually help, like, 启发一点, you know, ideas or whatever's going on with yourself lah. Then maybe you will find out more about yourself also.
Can I add something on this?
Yes, of course.
Yeah, like, I think it's also quite different from talking to a friend, because a lot of times friends definitely have our back, but sometimes talking to a professional counselor will help us to just see our blind spots. I mean, I can be honest, like, there was a period of time where I also, earlier this year, I also went for therapy.
Wow.
Yeah, because I felt like I wanted to work on myself. There are things that I think there are some just not very healthy habits that I was having, you know, whether it's my inner life and that kind of stuff.
Yes.
So I would encourage, you know, everyone who like you said, you don't have to have like a thing, each on thing.
Yeah.
Sometimes there's that stigma, right?
Yes.
But actually, you know, it's something that is for everyone. I think especially today where it's like online world can be 很容易被受打击, you know.
Yes.
Yeah.
Wow, so yeah, actually there are helplines out there where you can actually reach out to you know, the helpline if you are feeling any sort of negative way. Yeah, you can actually call the National Care Hotline at 1-800-202-6868. It's on the screen right there.
Yes, and of course the easiest way is to always check on your family, your friends, find out whether they're okay, how are they doing, or if you yourself, you are not feeling too well, or you have things on your mind, just speak to them. Find people to speak to. And to me, I feel that that's the best way.
Wow. I've never actually been to a therapy session before, but I'm quite interested to actually find out more.
You should.
Yeah, and hearing how it helped you, I think it's very good. It's more self-awareness, right? More than anything else.
I mean, I can share a little bit of my experience. I went in quite determined. I had a mind map of all my problems.
Not going to.
And then like I was like, oh, you know, come, I want to fix it. Of course, it's not, in the end, it wasn't like that.
Yeah.
Of course, the process was it also took its own process. But I think when you go into therapy, sometimes you might have an idea what you have, you know, things that you're struggling with that you are aware about, people have told you, you know, recurring habits, recurring themes. But sometimes when you go there, then the therapist will also help to like unpack these things. But actually, you might not even know, like whether it's from your childhood or, you know, certain experience when you were young. I think a lot of times, like, You never know, those things actually cause some of the feelings and some of these like habits that you're having right now.
Yes, definitely everyone actually faces stress. Whether you are male, female, young, old, I mean, we all face stress, and which our students' mental wellness are very important as well, which is why we have new measures in school to help students cope with COVID-19 stress as well.
Yeah. So, I don't know about Marcus, back in secondary, because Campus Superstar was when you were in secondary school?
Yeah, I was in sec 3.
And then what was your CCA then?
I played water polo.
So it wasn't music or anything?
No. That's it. Like, at the side, you know, I was doing, like, maybe in primary school, I was doing music then, in the choir and stuff like that.
Okay.
Yeah, I played water polo,
Right.
Missed this. Anyway, you were saying?
No, so because in during the COVID-19 situation, I mean, CCAs were taken away. Because students were not able to gather in. Yeah, but the good news now is that if most of the students are vaccinated, then the CCAs will be brought back with like safe management measures. So it's just good news that we're just sharing.
And there are definitely a few updates, like the common last topics, the CLT will be removed from the 2021 GCE exams.
What? Where was it when I was in secondary school? I saw one! I go back to secondary school.
I mean,
now
it will definitely help to reduce the stress.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, if not, you always have to keep revisioning and all that. I think in this period, I think everybody just, you know, we just need to help each other out.
I mean, right now, really, I just hope that everyone can take care of their mental wellness. And of course, for all the updates, constant updates and everything, just check everything out on gov.sg and you'll be good.
Yes. Okay, can we give another song?
Yeah, sure. Okay, so Just now the song was quite 有点悲伤, very sad. So yeah. I'll switch it up. I'll do a song. This is my first, you know, my first release. It's called 这是我的表白,
wow,
My Confession.
Okay. When was the release?
Back in 2019, I think. Wow. November 2019.
Okay.
I can share something special lah. So this song was actually inspired by, I actually went on a dating show in China.
Oh! What? Can we watch
it? How did it turn out?
Yeah, did you find anybody?
It's called 心相惊大会.
Okay. I think I've heard of it before.
So like there's Fei Cheng Wu around this show lah. So
right.
Yeah, then I 有点不可思议, but anyway, I was asked to go on. And then on the show, I think I saw a lot of different types of like 表白, a lot of confessions.
Wow. So
some people like write song, you know, pie, you know, like montage, photo montage, or some people, you know, wrote notes, or some people were quite hesitant.
Mm-hmm.
So that got me thinking, like, what is my ideal confession look
right.
like?
Right. Yeah, so this is the one.
No,
the
for
song.
Me, for me, I thought like, okay, I was thinking like, wow, you know, I want to do this and that, you know, right. go 华丽的摆设. But at the end of the day, I think what works is like, it's just something that is the ideal confession is something that is straight from the heart, something honest, sincere, and that will work. So for me, my version or my way of doing that is through song. So I just wrote that into this song. Just right. 我的表白.
Okay.
Alright, let's hear it.
Okay.
Oh, you're gonna fantasize about the song. Is
we're gonna take it as a 表白 now.
Mm-hmm. 事情我不在乎，你是我想认识的女孩，这是我的表白。I think it's a little crazy, I'm feeling kinda dizzy. The more and more I talk to you, I wanna call you baby. Got a feeling I'm for you and you're for me. 让我们在一起， 看着你在面前那单纯的笑脸，眼神就会浮现幸福的画面，我不会再等待，不会继续徘徊，不知为何会这样，开始像小鹿乱撞。我只想说，我就是对你有好感。在的镜头啊，不傻，心中在不停的喊。How would I get to know 这个事情我不在乎，你是我想认识的女孩，这是我的表白。 Hey, yeah, yeah, oh, oh. 我就为何会这样，敢像小鹿乱撞。 我只想说，我就是对你有好感。他的镜头啊飘下，心中在不停呐喊。How would I get to know you？ 其他事情我不在乎，你是我想认识的女孩，这是我的表白。不知该不该。
谢谢一首，这是我的表白。哇！
this song, right, brings me back to my school days.
Really?
Yeah, 它就有一个很青春、很阳光的那种很 纯洁的那种爱情的那种感觉
yeah.
It reminds me of back in school, right?
Does,
remember, during Valentine's Day, I brought a bouquet of flowers.
Really?
几天没有吃饭，攒了钱买了。 Then it was during recess, I went to this girl. Aww. I confessed to her, and then instantly got rejected.
Aww.
Then the whole school laughed at me for like a few days, but it's okay.
But the encouragement is that sometimes the piapa is not so, it's of course for them, but it's for yourself because you're being true to yourself.
Yes, yes. Of course, and we are being brave towards
exactly.
our love.
Yes. Okay, how about you? What's your biggest piapa?
My biggest piapa.
Can say it all.
Well, I've never used the song or anything like that.
Oh.
I'm more like a bit more detailed.
Ah, okay,
so
okay.
I think what I did before was like I wrote a note, like letter.
Ah, handwritten note. Okay.
I think these things like 不能用钱买的东西比较珍贵
yes, yeah. Yeah, yeah, secondary schools yeah, everybody will receive notes
here and there. Actually, you say it right, because this song also, the inspiration also came from a bit like 谢谢你爱我, that kind of feels yeah, so I wanted to write this kind of like 比较轻快的一首歌曲 yeah, 送给大家
yes. wow. And because of this song feeling so like young and fresh, right? Uh-huh. Felicia in the comment section says that she really miss you competing in the campus superstar.
Yeah, that was a really good time. I think 可以遇到那么多的志同道合的朋友, you know, so many people who love music,
yeah.
Same age group, just trying to, you know, do what we do.
Yeah.
You know, it was very heartening to see. It was a very fun experience.
Oh, it's really great though that all of your passion, I mean, three of you, Sean, Ben, and yourself, you know, for 14 years and you guys are still so into music and all that, I think, wow, it's very amazing.
Yeah, it's precious. And also to just to make friends in the industry is also very nice.
Mm.
And how do you actually keep that passion going?
How? Wow, good question. I think, okay, then, I think once I graduated, I made the decision to do music, I think I never looked back.
Wow.
Because before that, I think I was a little bit hesitant because I didn't study music. I studied something totally different. But like, but when I decided, I think once I went, I just like, I think I want to go all the way.
Yeah.
Yes, yeah.
Yes,
and
then, yes.
I mean, I guess this like album and all these songs is also like, it's also a mark, a milestone for me in my journey.
Mm.
And I hope that, you know, not just this is my first album. Hopefully there's more, you know, to come and more songs that I can bring for everyone.
Yes, and I believe this is the spirit, right?
Yeah, it's the perseverance, spirit, yes. Correct.
And everyone watching this, doesn't matter how old you are, doesn't matter who you are, what you do, it's the perseverance and determination that actually gets you far. But of course, on the goal of chasing your dream, right?
Yeah.
There's one thing you need to do first, take your vaccine.
Yeah.
Before that, ,什么都不用讲,先去打针先.
Correct, we're trying to chase you to go and get your vaccine now, okay? Not your dreams, Now it's vaccine first, then your dreams comes later, okay?
Yep.
Yeah, so... it's a very good that all the students now are more or less all like a lot of percentage. It's a very high percentage that you guys are vaccinated. So very good job. Congratulations.
Yeah, but of course, please do not forget about our seniors at home. Yeah, encourage them, take their vaccine to keep them safe. Really, this vaccination is to protect yourself and everyone around you.
Yes, correct. Okay, very good. So Marcus, Where can we find your songs on Spotify, right?
Yeah. So I mean, if you like what you hear, you can follow me on my social media handles. You know, it's Lee Joey Mark. Is it here? Okay, never mind. It's okay. Lee Joey.
It's there.
Ah. Wow, thank you. Yeah, Lee Joey Marcus. Yeah, I can support. You know, local music. And of course, all my stuff is also online, as I said. And also, just want to share something special is that I also have a physical albums as well. Yeah.
So, wow.
Sorry, this is a sample copy. So only have one
It's okay.
Oh, it's okay.
I found it on Spotify already.
Okay, thank you so much. Yeah. So it's an album booklet. So each song also has like a specific Boodle sticker. You know, so for just now, 这是我的表白 is a sunflower. So because in the MV, there was I use that to like present to the girl. And so this is not available yet. But it's only available in Taiwan. But I'm trying to consolidate group order. So you can, if you want to pre-order this, it's at bit.ly. So bit.ly/Marcus album. So my name, Marcus Album.
Okay.
I believe they can also find the details. They can also find the details on your Instagram page.
Yes, yes. I'll share more on my Instagram as well. Yeah.
Do it.
Great.
Yeah.
Wow, okay, we're very excited and very happy to have you here with us today.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank
so
you
much.
For showing us your amazing vocals and your songs.
Yes. We definitely hope that you can achieve more and constantly get better and provide us with better songs in your future music career, right?
Yes.
Thank you so much, Marcus.
Thank you so much, Marcus. Thank you.
Thank you,
everyone, for watching us. We will see you on Monday, 8:30 p.m.
拜拜。
拜拜。
Yes, I need a closing.
Bye.